Hey, just wanted to thank you for tuning in to another episode of Muley Story Monday. This week we're with Santley Sawyer. He has some really true dirty Giants that he's going to show us and tell us a few stories and give us a few tips. But before we start, I just want to remind you guys about our contest we're doing. We're giving away a free bow. All you have to do is go to our shop, pick up one of our hats, and then tag us in the photos that you have with our hats. And at the end of the year, we're going to do a contest. We're all going to vote. Whoever has the best photo is going to win a bow. We're working on other prizes right now still, so we'll keep you updated. All right, here we go. Okay, so here we are with Santley Sawyer.
Now, how many big bucks do you think you've killed over the years?
Over 100,
yeah, because we're here at his house right now. He has 8 big deer, and he says this isn't even a fraction of what he killed. So, I don't know, just tell us a little bit about your hunts and how you were able to kill so much, what you did that was different than everyone else.
Well, I don't know. I done lots of looking.
So
I had lots of time, and I drove around in all the mountains and every place I could find, you know, in my area.
Mm-hmm.
I knew just about where all the game were.
Oh, really? So you would actually go out and find them pre-hand?
I'd go out and camp, and we'd have a camp for 3 or 4 days. I'd just look the whole country over, and if they wouldn't, what I see wanted there, I'd go somewhere else.
Wow. So you didn't have binoculars or anything, did you?
No, I didn't have binoculars.
So how would you locate your deer, kind of? What would you?
I would look at the signs on the ground for the
oh, like tracks. Their tracks?
Yeah.
Hmm.
And it's where I spotted most of the big tracks. And then go stay in that area until I found the deer. I'd locate them. And stay there until I found them.
What advice would you give someone who wants to get better at tracking deer? Because I feel like that's kind of a lost art nowadays, because everyone has binoculars and they kind of go that route. But what advice would you give someone to kind of start tracking and how to get good at it?
Well, it's just, they just got to have a knack for it and make sure their tracking's a good one, you know. You can tell by the tracks if they look at enough of them,
mm-hmm.
which are the big ones and which aren't.
Really?
The best time to go and look for them tracks is right after a storm. Rain.
Kind of maybe tell us a story of when you tracked one down. Can you remember when you tracked one? And were any of these ones that you tracked?
This one I did track.
Oh, this one right here.
It was just, it had rained the day before or something, and we went out and camped out there.
Uh-huh.
And I see the tracks, you know, where they went through fresh during the night. They weren't there the day before, you know, so followed them. Got a good look at them, you know.
Yeah.
But they were what I wanted. This was in November.
Oh, really?
Usually, no deer has velvet on his horns, even, you know.
Yeah.
It's the only one I ever seen that had velvet in after October, you know, like.
Mm-hmm.
But on a late Arizona hunt. And that was in what year?
It was 68, I believe.
Is that when you killed most of your deer in the 60s?
70s, 80s. Yeah, well, let's see. Raquel was born in 88, and you were still killing big deer.
Years ago, it was legal for party hunting.
Oh, yeah.
One man could shoot all the deer, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And the most I ever killed was I killed 8 deer one day. And they were all as big as these.
No way.
I had the guys I was hunting with, they were out of Los Angeles area.
Mm-hmm.
And I was taking them hunting for 5 or 6 days they hunted. And they got lots of shooting. Come in, they say, I've done 4 or 5 shots here. And then they told me, they said, well, we got to go home, you know. I used to be a guide.
Oh, so you actually guided back then. Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, somebody else is going to have to shoot for you then. And I had to make a drive. You know, all of them in the drive, they'd be made.
They would quit at hunting season.
Oh, you would quit your job every hunting season?
Why? Why? He would quit. Who's white-headed? I would worry myself sick. He would just do side jobs. He meant make money. He always made money. The bills were paid. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I worried. I wasn't working. I didn't work till late 70s. So,
so just because you loved it so much, that was your passion.
Why? But I done a lot of hunting.
So I remember you last time kind of telling me too that you would almost purposely scare the deer to see where they would go when they get scared.
Yeah, right. Yeah, and that's one of the best ways to really find out where to look for, you know, is if you jump them. They usually have a hiding place where they feel safe,
mm-hmm.
and that's where they'll go. So if you follow them, well, you'll find more or less where they go. Like season starts, they go in the areas they feel the safest.
When the hunt starts.
And it starts when them hunters start moving in, they know.
So, would you find that, like, even if you scared them, the deer would be back? Like, let's say you missed a deer, would it be back where it was living?
They will.
They'll come back?
90% of them will come back. You jump them, and like you go out and look for them.
Mm-hmm.
And they ain't not shooting or anything, just looking for them. If you jump them, 9 times out of 10, they'll be there the next time you go back in the same area.
Huh.
They will go back to the same areas.
Yeah, I think that's actually really good advice, because when I go scouting, I'm always kind of nervous that when I scare a deer, that it's not going to come back.
They will.
But, yeah. So you almost did that purposely just to see which route they would take, and they usually take the same routes that you found?
They take the same route. If they get away once, they'll try to be in the same place. And that's where I find most of them, and that's where I hunt for them, because they'll be there.
Thanks for watching this week's episode of Muley Story Monday. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any awesome content, and we'll see you next Monday with another story.